Hello friends, welcome to Poonam Dua classes. Thanks a lot to all my students for doing a great hard work for your literature studies. All the students who really studied religiously, rigorously, were very much happy, very elated to see this question paper. And it is your hard work that made you find the question paper easy. Let us discuss British drama recent papers so that the current batch of mine may also be benefited. Please keep in mind this is very short analysis and can be useful only if you have already done your deep studies. Literature is such a delightful subject. Please enjoy it slowly, steadily. We have got the whole year to study the subjects you are allotted, and many students still approach to my academy in last month to ask for shortcuts. Please respect the subject you have chosen. Run after getting knowledge. Do not run just after spoon-fed answers. Please leave your inputs in comments and let us start the discussion now. In total, you are supposed to attempt the 5 questions, out of which question number 1 is compulsory. Question number 1, which is related to RTC. So let us discuss the first RTC now. You will be given the 5 RTCs and you need to attempt any 4 out of it. So let us start with the first one, to be or not to be. That is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles and by opposing end them. To be or not to be. This is the question. And अगर आपने हेमलेट पढ़ा है और आप इन लाइन से acquainted ना हो, ये possible नहीं है. To be or not to be, that is the question, is the most famous soliloquy in the works of Shakespeare, and I must say quite possibly the most famous soliloquy in literature. The soliloquy is essentially about life or death, to live or not to live, to be or not to be. Hamlet discusses how painful and miserable human life is and how death means specifically suicide here, would be preferable. Would it not be for the fearful uncertainty of what comes after death? Living, according to him, is a passive state at present and dying is an active state. But in order to reach the condition of death, one has to take some action in life. At present, he is contemplating about his whole situation. His father had recently died and his mother is about to marry the brother of dead king. So he is contemplating whom to believe, whom not to believe, whether to be, whether not to be, what to do, what action can be taken after he has maybe come to know through the ghost of his father that Claudius was the murderer of him. Next one, option B. I think a woman fetching a man's slippers is a disgusting sight. I think a good deal more of you for throwing them in my face. Who cares for a slip? If you have read Pygmalion, the word slipper should ring a bell in your mind. Eliza has started taking interest in doing chores for Higgins. Eliza reveals a bit of her heart regarding Higgins, but while talking about her future, the two begin to argue. Higgins mocks her in her old accent and Eliza advises him not to sneer at her. Higgins says, please listen carefully what Higgins says here in this context. You are a fool. I think a woman fetching a man's slipper is a disgusting sight. Did I ever fetch your slippers? I think a good deal more of you for throwing them in my face. No use slaving for me and then saying you want to be cared for. Who cares for a slave? If you come back for the sake of good fellowship, for you will get nothing else. So Higgins is here trying to say to Eliza that do not try to be my slave, try to be my fellow, try to be my companion. Henry Higgins plans to transform a Cockney flower girl into an English lady. Eliza Doolittle becomes a student and learns high society manners and dictions. And once the experiment is done, what will happen to her place in society and to her heart? This is what the concern of Eliza is at present. Next one, option C. When I behold the heavens, then I repent and curse thee, wicked Mephistopheles, because thou hast deprived me of those joys Dr. Foster's by Christopher Marlowe clearly. Foster begins to repent when he knows that hell is his ultimate place now and he can never be a part of heaven. That he has made a contact with devil, Mephistopheles tries to console Foster by telling him that heaven is not such a glorious place and that humans are maybe more wonderful than anything in heaven. Heaven was actually created for humans, na? Then how can heaven be greater than human? Humans are greater than heaven. This is what Mephistopheles is trying to teach to Dr. Faustus. Faustus contemplates Faustus thinks redemption again and quickly blames Mephistopheles for depriving him for heaven. Mephistopheles reveals his strong character as he quickly responds to Faustus by reminding him that he, Faustus was the one who initiated the relationship with Lucifer and Mephistopheles is just a slave, so he was just following the directions. It is actually Faustus who is responsible for his own damnation. Next quote, option D, astride of a grave and a difficult birth, down in the hole lingeringly the grave digger puts on the forceps. We have time to grow old. The air is full of our cries, but habit is a great detainer. Taken from Waiting for Godot. These are Vladimir's quote in reference to something that Pozzo said as he was leaving the stage in the second act. Pozzo is expressing his frustration about the concept of time and the passage of time. When Pozzo first appeared in the play, he was able to see and he had a servant named Lucky. In the scene, the current scene, the tables have turned, and what Pozzo says, listen carefully. One day he went dumb, one day I went blind, one day we will go deaf, one day we were born, and one day we shall die. Let me repeat. One day he went dumb, one day I went blind, one day we will go deaf, one day we were born, and one day we shall die. Now we get to know the response of Vladimir. The quote, the above quote, the above lines means that birth is the beginning of death. As soon as somebody is born, now the grave is already dug. Women give birth astride a grave suggests that life is only a brief flash of time, an instant, and death is the inevitable end. You can say death is the only reality which is decided as and when we are born. Time is ultimately rather meaningless when one's whole lifetime is considered into a brief moment. So whole life is nothing, actually a fixation of death. Next question, option number E. As imagination bodies forth the form of things unknown, the poet's pen turns them to shapes and gives to airy nothing. These lines are taken from Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream and spoken by Theseus. Before this line, he says a very beautiful phrase, listen carefully, the lunatic, the lover and the poet are of imagination, all compact. Basically, he says that lovers, madmen and poet, or you can say writers, imagine in a very creative manner about things that sane people, normal people just can't understand. All these people have such great imaginations that when they feel happy, they assume a god or some other supernatural being is bringing the happiness to all of them. So their imagination actually brings them happiness. This is what Theseus is trying to say in these lines. Poet ka jo pen hai, wo kisi bhi cheez ko kisi bhi cheez mein convert kar sakta hai. अब आपके ऐसे क्वेश्चन शुरू होते हैं जिसमें से आपको कोई चार क्वेश्चंस करने होंगे, ठीक है? और इनमें भी इंटरनल चॉइस है, तो दैट इज़ वेल एंड गुड फॉर यू. जूनेसियंस, द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, जूनेसियन कॉमेडी रीडायरेक्टेड अटैक्स फ्रॉम पर्सन्स टू वर्ड्स, फॉलीज एंड फॉइबल्स, गलतियाँ, डिस्कस विद रेफरेंस टू द एल्केमिस्ट. The first thing, you should have read Alchemist in detail. The Alchemist is a satiric comment on the real social conditions of its time, contemporary time, first performed in 1610. Johnson's satire, The Alchemist, It relates to human materialism, which was set in the contemporary London, and there are many characters in the play. You need to learn all the characters to answer any question of alchemist. The characters in the play Alchemist are personifications of various kinds of negative qualities, vices in the society. For example, Sir Epicure Memon is represented as greed and corruption, Subtle as cunning man who knows how to manipulate people, Dull as prostitution, Face as opportunist, Kestrel and aggressor, Tame Pliant as the representation of elastic and overruled person, Dapper as a knave and innocent person, Drugger a big-headed, Surly, impolite, Tribulation and Ananias as hypocrite and dogmatic respectively. Through these characters, Johnson mocks completely all the human weaknesses, follies and gullibility. इस इक्वेशन का और पार्ट देखते हैं. Tragic irresolution is the dramatic strength of Dr. Foster's discourse. The full name, The Tragic History of the Life and Death of Dr. Foster's, commonly referred to simply as Dr. Foster's, is an Elizabethan tragedy by Christopher Marlowe, based on German stories about the titular character Faust. अब जानते हैं इस word का मतलब irresolution. Irresolution का मतलब होता है कि decision ना ले पाना किसी चीज़ का, lack of taking decision or lack of looking towards any purpose. Irresolution, this term not only plagues some other literature characters like Hamlet when he cannot decide whether to believe in ghost or in his uncle. The same irresolution plagues Dr. Faustus when he cannot determine to break the shackles of Mephistopheles, hold upon his soul and to contemplate God. Tragic irresolution demonstrates an important, very important universal principle: for every action there is a consequence. This is the reason. Thus, tragic irresolution is the basis for the dramatic strength of this morality play. This is a morality play as well. Everybody knows that it is based upon the karmas. What we will do, we will get the same in return. You can say tragic irresolution is actually the hamartia, the action of characters which bring to him his or her downfall. ऐसा ही downfall Hamlet का हुआ था जब वो decision नहीं ले पाते हैं, और ऐसा ही downfall Dr. Foster's का होता है जबकि वो एक गलत decision ले लेते हैं. Foster's who sought the devil to oppose God seeks God's mercy in the end and his innate forgiveness to rescue him from the devil. So the tragic irresolution Foster's is what frames the whole plot of the play. जो रॉन्ग डिसीजन फॉस्टर्स ने लिया, वही इस पूरे प्लॉट की क्रिएशन करता है. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. ट्रेस द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ बेकेट्स मार्टिरडम इन टीएस एलियट्स मर्डर इन द कैथेड्रल. मर्डर इन द कैथेड्रल इज अ वर्स ड्रामा बाय टीएस एलियट, फर्स्ट परफॉर्म्ड इन 1935. You people need to be very good with dates, and you people need to be very good about the setting date as well. This 1935 play portrays the assassination of Thomas Becket in Canterbury Cathedral during the reign of Henry II in 1170. Martyrdom is undoubtedly very central theme in this play, Murder in the Cathedral by T.S. Eliot. Many martyrs are prayed to, particularly in the Christian faiths, as saints. Martyrs ko saints mana jata hai. Thomas Becket's murder and his status as martyr has dominated King Henry England's reign for us, as well as the contemporary people of that time. It is a very simple play, not with many characters. You can go for it, and a very striking, crisp play by Eliot, I'll say. The play's most striking feature is the use of a chorus in the classical Greek manner. A very good play to be covered. Next one, which is the or part of question 3. Critically comment on Shakespeare's use of romantic comedy formula in A Midsummer Night's Dream. Let us talk about Midsummer Night's Dream now, a very famous romantic comedy. You need to know not only the play in detail, but the features of romantic comedy as well. Romantic comedies must have a happy ending. The first feature, आप लोग सब कुछ नोट करते रहिए. वन कैरेक्टर चेंजेस हिज बिलीव व्यू पॉइंट और एम्ब्रेसेस समथिंग अबाउट दी अदर कैरेक्टर. द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट आई टोल्ड, हैप्पी एंडिंग होती है. किसी ना किसी मेजर कैरेक्टर के व्यू पॉइंट्स चेंज होते हैं. दे ओवरकम द कन्फ्लिक्ट दैट केप्ट देम अपार्ट. कुछ लवर्स होते हैं जिनके बीच में कुछ कन्फ्लिक्ट्स आ जाते हैं जिसकी वजह से वो दूर रहते हैं. एंड दे फॉल इन लव ऑल ओवर अगेन एंड गिव द स्टोरी अ वेरी सिंपल सेटिस्फाइंग कंक्लूजन. या तो प्ले विद इन प्ले होता है या कुछ ना कुछ सुपर नेचुरल होता है. और इसी जॉनरे के अंदर बहुत सारी मूवीज़ भी बनी हैं विच आर वेरी पॉपुलर, लाइक यू कैन से जब वी मेट, नमस्ते लंदन, दिल चाहता है. वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पॉपुलर फिल्म जॉनरेज ऑफ टुडेज मूवीज़ वॉज ऑल्सो पॉपुलर इन द टाइम ऑफ विलियम शेक्सपियर, वी कैन से. शुड नॉट बी टफ इफ यू नो द प्ले. अ मिडसमर नाइट्स ड्रीम इज़ वन ऑफ शेक्सपियर्स ग्रेटेस्ट कॉमेडीज एंड इट इज़ नॉट लिमिटेड टू वन सिंगल कॉमेडी एंड मिक्सेस मेनी सेवरल डायमेंशंस एंड सबप्लॉट्स एज वेल. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. हैमलेट्स कैरेक्टर इज द प्रिवेलेंस ऑफ द एब्स्ट्रैक्टिंग एंड जनरलाइजिंग हैबिट ओवर द प्रैक्टिकल. Discuss with reference to the play as a revenge tragedy. शेक्सपियर के तो सभी प्लेज बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट हैं. सेम गोज विद द हैमलेट. फर्स्ट परफॉर्म्ड अराउंड 1600, हैमलेट टेल्स द स्टोरी ऑफ अ प्रिंस हूज ड्यूटी टू रिवेंज हिज फादर्स डेथ एंटेंगल्स हिम इन फिलोसॉफिकल प्रॉब्लम्स एंड दोज काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स विच ही कैनॉट रिजॉल्व. Shakespeare's best known play is widely regarded as the most influential literary work ever written. Questions of habit and custom recur throughout William Shakespeare's Hamlet. The play Hamlet is characterized by many themes. They include revenge, mystery, murder, tragedy, etc. And most articles about the play deal with the revenge of Hamlet towards Claudius, and others give an overview of the characters in the play. Revenge, no doubt, is the central theme of this play. An important theme in the play, as it seems, is revenge. Side by side, but it shows the habit of procrastination of Hamlet as well. This is what we mean by the term habit. Habit is a terrible thing for anybody. It is not easy to get used to of doing something which you can't do. For an evil person, it is not possible to do something good. For a good person, it is not possible to do something evil. Something which was being done by Claudius. He murdered his brother and did not feel bad about it. But it is also a good thing in the being good can also become a habit. Hamlet is continuously in the habit of dilemma. Procrastination, we can say, to be or not to be. Along with the habits of both the parties, this play goes on. Claudius is involved in the evil habits and Hamlet is involved in procrastination. It is a typical revenge tragedy like the Spanish tragedy. The two hero faces the two obstacles and to find out who the murderers are and then to get himself into a position where he can kill them. So it becomes a revenge tragedy as well. Next question, jo ki a part hai question number 4 ka, he discuss the Playboy of the Western World as an extravagant comedy and a dramatic building showman. The Playboy of the Western World is a three-act play written by Irish playwright John Millington Synge and first performed at the Abbey Theatre, Dublin on 26 January 1907. The Playboy of the Western World, एक comedy है, satiric और tragic elements की we can say, and Synge wanted his audience to laugh at his characters but also wanted the audience to notice their humanity, for they have their faults and defects, everybody has. It tells the story of Christy Mahon, a young man running away from his farm claiming he killed his father, and the play can be seen to some extent as a dramatic building showman. In little, the growth of Christy Mahon is the result of his of the impetus and directions given by the community of the town Mayo. The next one is about Pygmalion. Unlikely conversions, miraculous transformations and providential assistance are inseparable from comedy. Discuss with reference to Shaw's Pygmalion. Pygmalion, which is a play by G.B. Shaw, George Bernard Shaw. Named after a Greek mythological figure, it was first presented on stage to public in 1913. Pygmalion is a comedy of manners because it largely satirizes the upper class of British society. The manners and customs of the upper class are mocked subtly through the upper class linguist Professor Higgins' molding of the so-called lower class flower girl Eliza Doolittle, into a lady by refining her dressing sense, her personality, her speech. Pygmalion ek comedy hai, comedy of ideas, which is concerned with manners and class, and it is a criticism of social barriers and class distinctions, and side by side, it upholds the ideal of equal opportunity of wealth and education for both the genders. Regardless of class and gender, it provides opportunities of wealth and education to all. And Pygmalion, I must say, is a very, very refreshing mixture of comedy and satire. Next question. ये और पार्ट है क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 का. क्रिटिकली कमेंट ऑन वेटिंग फॉर गोडॉट एज अ प्ले एस्टैब्लिशिंग न्यू कन्वेंशंस फॉर मॉडर्न थिएटर. वेटिंग फॉर गोडॉट इज़ अ प्ले बाय सैमुअल बेकेट इन विच टू कैरेक्टर्स व्लैडिमीर एंड एस्ट्रेगन एंगेज्ड इन अ वैरायटी ऑफ डिस्कशंस एंड एनकाउंटर्स वाइल अवेटिंग द गोडॉट फिगर, द टाइटुलर फिगर हु नेवर अराइव्स. Samuel Beckett's Waiting for Godot is often used as an example of a work straddling two moments, modernism and postmodernism. This play, I must say, is a landmark in modern drama when it was first performed in Paris. It originally stunned the audience but within a short period of time, audiences came to the theatre prepared for a wholly new dramatic experience. मॉडर्निज्म समझते हैं थोड़ा सा. मॉडर्निज्म कैन बी डिस्क्राइब्ड एज एन अर्ली 20th सेंचुरी मोमेंट डिफाइंड बाय फॉर्मल इनोवेशन एंड द क्वेस्ट फॉर मीनिंग एंड सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन इन एन इंक्रीजिंगली फ्रेगमेंटेड वर्ल्ड. ये वो टाइम था जब रिसेंटली फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर हुई थी एंड लोग बहुत ज़्यादा एलिनेटेड और बहुत ज़्यादा वॉर से अफेक्टेड हो गए थे. फोकसिंग ऑन द फिलोसफी बिहाइंड वेटिंग फॉर गोडॉट एंड इट्स रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ टाइम, place, language, it is possible to get deeper into some element of modernism. Modernism के क्या क्या elements हैं जो इस play में हैं देखिए. Characters seem to looking for an identity. Characters seem to be purposeless. Characters seem to be alienated and very much fragmented. Waiting for Godot, hence we can say, is centered into two characters, Vladimir and Estragon, waiting on a country road for the elusive figure Godot. While they wait, they pass the time with a series of repetitive activities. Soon, Pozzo and Lucky appear, and the interaction between the four characters provides a brief description that post-World War people were facing. Again, you need to know the play in detail to elaborate your answer. कि किस तरीके से हमारे characters जो हैं वो identity के लिए search करते हैं, किस तरीके से वो purposeless लगते हैं, किस तरीके से वो alienated और fragmented लगते हैं. Next question, question number 6. Look back in anger examines the relationship between the individual and society in the modern age, critically comment. It was in the year 1956. आप ईयर्स याद रखिए अच्छे से. इट वॉज इन द ईयर 1956 व्हेन जॉन ऑस्बर्न लुक बैक इन एंगर वॉज फर्स्ट स्टेज्ड एंड इट इज सेट इन द पीरियड ऑफ पोस्ट कॉलोनियल ब्रिटिश एम्पायर. द सेटिंग ऑफ द ड्रामा इज द आफ्टरमैथ ऑफ द सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर दैट हैज़ ब्रॉट अबाउट फ्रस्ट्रेशन एंड डिप्रेशन अमंग द न्यूली राइजिंग एजुकेटेड कम्युनिटी. The hero of Osborne's play is a young person, Jimmy Potter, belonging to a class of social inferiority. Osborne's Look Back in Anger has a great bearing on the modern literary trend to represent the growing frustration and confusion among the young people, and it enabled a great contribution to the literary canon of the new wave British theatre by concentrating mainly on the post-war youth's frustration and isolation resulting from the unfulfilled promises given by the welfare state project just after the Second World War. सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर के बाद किस तरीके से यंग एजुकेटेड लोगों में एक तरीके का फ्रस्ट्रेशन आ रहा था बिकॉज ऑफ नॉट गेटिंग दी सूटेबल जॉब्स. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन सिक्स का ही और पार्ट है ये. डिस्कस द सेलियंट फीचर्स ऑफ एलिजाबेथन ट्रेजेडी विथ रेफरेंस टू द प्रिस्क्राइब्ड प्लेस. अपने किसी भी प्ले को या किसी इवन एक्सटर्नल प्ले को भी अगर आप बहुत अच्छे से जानते हैं तो उसको एज एन एग्जाम्पल दे सकते हैं. इफ़ यू नो ऑल द फीचर्स ऑफ एलिजाबेथन ट्रेजेडी. Looking at Elizabethan tragedy plays a combination of few elements make up the plot, coming together to make up the most tragic Shakespeare moments you can see. If you have read Dr. Foster's Hamlet, Macbeth, Othello, you may find some common features like the first one, a tragic hero. Please note down, a tragic hero in your course, Hamlet and Foster's can be considered to be the tragic heroes. Good against evil, Hamlet against Claudius and Faustus against himself. Next is Hamartia. The characters have a tragic flaw which I have discussed with my students many times, so will not go in detail. Tragic waste. Next feature is tragic waste. This is kind of a collateral damage. Not only the central characters but many other characters suffer and even die. Next is there is some kind of conflict. इनर या आउटर कुछ भी हो सकता है. वो हमारे दोनों ही कैरेक्टर्स हैमलेट और फॉस्टर्स के इनर कॉन्फ्लिक्ट से वो अपने आप से ही डिबेट कर रहे थे कि वेदर आई शुड गो फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर डिसीजन और नॉट. द सुपर नेचुरल घोस्ट विच इज़ फेरीज, मैकबेथ में भी थे, हैमलेट में भी थे, और फॉस्टर्स अपने आप में सुपर नेचुरल है. नेक्स्ट इज कथारसिस. कथारसिस जिसमें कि आपको फील होता है पिटी एंड फियर फॉर दोज कैरेक्टर्स. एंड वन मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज लैक ऑफ पोएटिक जस्टिस. जनरली इन हिंदी मूवीज दिस हैपन्स ना, दैट विलेन इज डिफीटेड इन द एंड एंड हीरो इज विक्टोरियस. बट वी सी लैक ऑफ पोएटिक जस्टिस इन एलिजाबेथन ट्रेजिडीज. यू कैन गिव एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फॉस्टर्स, मैकबेथ, ओथेलो एंड हैमलेट. यू मे रियली मेक दिस आंसर वेरी ब्यूटिफुल इफ यू स्टडी ऑल द अबव टर्म्स इन डेप्थ एंड ऑल द प्लेस टू वेरी थॉरली. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इसमें से आपको कोई दो शॉर्ट नोट्स करने हैं. माई स्टूडेंट्स हैव डन हैमलेट सोलिलोक्वे एंड रोमांटिक कॉमेडी. लेट अस डिस्कस द फर्स्ट वन. हैमलेट के बारे में तो आपको थोड़ा सा मेंशन करना ही पड़ेगा. इट इज़ शेक्सपियर्स लॉन्गेस्ट ड्रामा एंड स्टिल कंसिडर्ड अ पायनियर इन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. सेवरल फिल्म्स एंड प्लेज हैव बीन मेड एज अडेप्टेशंस फीचरिंग मेनी रिनाउंड एक्टर्स. हैमलेट इज़ द प्रिंस ऑफ डेनमार्क. ही इज़ अब्रोड स्टडिंग इन जर्मनी व्हेन हिज फादर द किंग डाइज एंड ही इज समॉन्ड बैक टू डेनमार्क इन ऑर्डर टू अटेंड हिज फादर्स फ्यूनरल. ऑलरेडी ड्राउनिंग इन ग्रीफ, हैमलेट बिकम्स इवन मोर अपसेट बाय द फैक्ट दैट हिज मदर हैज़ married to his uncle, the brother of a recently departed husband. And to really understand the plot development of Hamlet, one needs to understand the actual meaning and concept of each of Hamlet's soliloquies, since the text of that era is hard to understand for today's student. In these seven soliloquies, I'm repeating again, seven soliloquies are there. In these seven soliloquies, Hamlet shares his inner feeling, thought and plans for the future, and these soliloquies are the pivotal pillars of the drama and are still considered some of Shakespeare's most brilliant writing and the most famous one. It was a part of RTC as well. To be or not to be, that is the question. Study all the soliloquies and the sequence of soliloquies, then your answer will become very beautiful. Look at the next one, romantic comedy. This is a lottery question. Go back to the or part of question 3. I have told the features of romantic comedies, and if you are aware with Taming of the Shrew, Merchant of Venice, and of course your own subjects, Midsummer Night's Dream, you may use that as an example too. तो जितना भी आप शेक्सपियर के टाइम की रोमांटिक कॉमेडीज़ के बारे में जानते हैं, उन सभी फीचर्स के साथ जो कि क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 में डिस्कस किए गए हैं, एज एन एग्जाम्पल यू कैन मैंशन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज यूज़ ऑफ मिथ बाय शॉ इन पिग्मेलियन. स्टोरी ऑफ पिग्मेलियन, पिग्मेलियन का इंट्रोडक्शन मैं डिस्कस कर ही चुकी हूँ. मैं मिथ के बारे में बताऊँगी अब. द स्टोरी ऑफ पिग्मेलियन एंड गैलेटिया इज एन इंचेंटिंग मिथ अबाउट अ स्कल्पचर हु फेल इन लव विद हिज ओन स्कल्पचर. ही प्रेज टू गॉडेस एफ्रोडाइटी, जिसको कि हम वीनस भी कहते हैं, टू ब्रिंग द स्कल्पचर टू लाइफ बिकॉज ही प्लान्स फॉर इट टू बी हिज वाइफ एंड द गॉडेस ग्रांट्स हिज विश एंड एज अ रिजल्ट पिग्मेलियन एंड हिज क्रिएशन गैलेटिया लिव्ड हैप्पीली एवर आफ्टर. This myth is represented in modern day setting in the Pygmalion play by G.B. Shaw with minor changes, and Higgins you can say as Pygmalion and Eliza as Galatea. Next one is D, which we can say is the last part. The question is, we are supposed to write note about poetic drama and modernism. The poetic drama, पहले समझते हैं है क्या. Poetic drama is a great achievement of the modern age. It is a mixture of high seriousness and colloquial, simple language kind of element. Eliot, T.S. Eliot propounded the theory of poetic drama, and it was he who established its tradition in 20th century, and the example is Murder in the Cathedral. The Murder in the Cathedral is his first full-length poetic play. Modernism experimented with literary forms and expressions as exemplified by Ezra Pound. If any of you is preparing for UGC NET or PhD, they must be acquainted that Ezra Pound, a good friend of T.S. Eliot, gave the maxim, make it new. Very popular it is. So, baat karte hain wapis T.S. Eliot ke baare mein. T.S. Eliot was the one of the premier modernist writers, and Murder in the Cathedral is a modernist drama. Although older period ko represent karta hai, as an artistic moment, modernism constituted a rejection of the idealistic and artificial constructions of the romantic poets and offered a more critical and realistic look at the psychology of people living in the you can say changing landscape, changing areas of an increasingly urbanized and industrialized society. Murder in Cathedral, so we can say, is a verse drama by Eliot, first performed in 1935, that portrays the assassination of Thomas Becket in Canterbury Cathedral during the reign of Henry II in 1170. So Murder in Cathedral mixes both medieval and modern features in it. Let us understand the paper pattern now. MEG02 का February paper का भी मैं analysis video publish कर चुकी हूँ. You can see the link in description. MEG02 is a drama, as the name of the paper clarifies, and it is specifically British drama. The question pattern is more or less remains same, and very little changes have occurred during the recent years. It expects the students to answer total 100 marks questions. फर्स्ट पार्ट होता है जो कि कंपलसरी है, जिसमें कि आपको 5 आर्टिसीज दी जाती हैं. यू आर सपोज टू डू एनी 4, टोटल 20 मार्क्स, दैट मीन्स 5 मार्क्स ईच. द सेकेंड पार्ट इज टोटल ऑफ 4 एसे टाइप क्वेश्चंस टू बी अपियर्ड फॉर, जिसमें से कि आपको 6 दिए जाते हैं, 6 में से आपको कोई 4 अपियर करने होते हैं. उसमें भी इंटरनल चॉइस भी होती है, तो काफ़ी चॉइस ऑप्शंस होते हैं आपके पास. अगर आप 6 to 7 ड्रामास को अच्छे से प्रिपेयर करके जाते हैं, तो यू कैन अपियर वेल इन दिस एग्जाम. अगेन इन द एंड आई विल से थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो, बेस्ट ऑफ लक फॉर एग्जाम. अपने इनपुट्स को आप प्लीज़ कॉमेंट्स में मैंशन कर दीजिए, एंड डू नॉट फॉरगेट to share and subscribe the channel.